Hi, this is Dustin Madison with thefutureofsupplychains.com. Today my guest is Peter Balbus, Managing Director of Pragmaxis LLC. Peter specializes in assisting clients with their strategic innovation and performance improvement initiatives with a focus on strategic supply chain management. In this segment, Peter and I will be discussing some of the key learnings he has gained through his consulting work on how S&OP is changing the face of advanced supply chain management. Well, welcome, Peter. Could you please provide a brief background of yourself?
Well, thank you, Dustin. Great to be chatting with you once again. I would describe myself as a consultant who specializes in strategic innovation management with an emphasis on strategic sourcing and supply chain transformation. I help clients accelerate their achievement of world-class operational performance and customer fulfillment capabilities. My educational foundation includes an undergraduate degree from MIT in chemical engineering and completion of the University of Chicago Executive Program in Finance and Strategy. I also hold professional certification as a Master Business Innovator through a great program offered by Illinois Institute of Technology. My clients are varied in terms of their size and industry. Most are mid to large scale firms with complex global operations and are spread across multiple industrial segments, including manufacturing, chemicals, energy, and electronics. But I've also done some significant engagements with client food and beverage and office product segments, as well as with the portfolio companies for a couple of leading private equity firms. Prior to joining Pragmaxis in 2001, I held senior management practice positions with KPMG, CSE Index, and Booz Allen.
Thank you. And how would you define and summarize what S&OP is and what it means?
Well, in my work with clients, I generally define S&OP as a set of integrated corporate-wide planning processes that enable senior management to strategically direct operations with the intent to achieve superior levels of performance on a sustained long-term basis. It means integrating customer-focused sales plans, historic data, and predictive analysis with supply chain management to enhance customer fulfillment capabilities, drive efficiency, improve resiliency, and maintain agility to respond rapidly to changes in customer, market, and supply dynamics. Successful S&OP processes align operations with the corporate business strategy. As companies have become more global and face rising complexity, volatility, and uncertainty, the importance of S&OP is increasing. Especially in those industries that are well served, where we see growth is flattening, S&OP becomes critical to competitive survival.
Well, this seems like a reasonably simple and straightforward concept. So why then are there so many companies struggling to design and implement effective S&OP processes? What do you see as the key to successful S&OP initiatives?
Well, in most companies, senior management believes they've made great strides in reducing costs, improving inventory turnover, managing complexity, and enhancing customer satisfaction. Reality is that data from their own financial statements tend to say otherwise. Solving supply chain challenges by building effective S&OP processes is a complex and highly detailed undertaking. In my work with supply chain managers and corporate executives, I emphasize paying particularly close attention to five key aspects of 21st century advanced supply chain management. First, we see longer supply chains. Managing the complexity of global markets and global sourcing means building and maintaining extended supply chains, both in terms of geographic reach and in terms of deeper integration with strategic suppliers. Global corporations increasingly are becoming vertically integrated in their supply chains. And this is a distinct reversal from 10 to 15 years ago, when companies were striving to become modular and decentralized in their operations, essentially outsourcing anything not deemed core to their business. Extended supply chains also mean greater risks. In 2012, over 85% of supply chain leaders experienced a significant disruption in their operations. The second key aspect is the existence of multiple supply chains within the organization. For a variety of reasons, including multiple core businesses, global markets, growth or acquisition, and the continued existence of legacy IT systems, many companies today, and virtually all global corporations, have multiple supply chains. By itself, the existence of multiple supply chains is not really a problem, especially if these multiple supply networks are logically segmented, say by end markets, regional operations, or technology. The problem is that too many companies with multiple supply chains also have multiple S&OP processes, often one for each supply chain. According to a recent market research report I read, over 63% of companies surveyed reported having multiple S&OP processes. In fact, today, the typical global company has no fewer than five S&OP processes, with each process often based on different operating and governance models. The inevitable conflicts and disruptions that result from this kind of patchwork approach are sometimes worse than having no S&OP process at all. The third key aspect I like to emphasize is that planning must be tied to execution. This is especially crucial for supply chain agility and efficiency. Now, one might think that this is an obvious operational imperative. The problem arises over the fact that traditionally, planning and operations have always been in separate organizations, typically planning at the corporate level, while operations have been managed at the divisional functional level. In this same research report, over 90% of companies responding stated that they believe that a strong S&OP process improves supply chain agility and efficiency. All well and good, but only 13% of these same companies report actually having tied S&OP planning to their execution activities. The fourth is in what I would call significant gaps in S&OP delivery capability. While the overwhelming majority of companies today have ongoing S&OP initiatives, significantly fewer have fully implemented these planning processes, and even fewer are reporting successful outcomes among those that have. There are large gaps often in the effectiveness in S&OP from planning to execution, as much as a 60% gap between the performance levels a company seeks to achieve and the actual performance delivered through these S&OP processes. The fifth is the strengthening of horizontal processes. Horizontal processes tie the organization together and give it structure, connectivity, and a sense of common purpose. In my view, S&OP is the single most important horizontal process there is in business. In today's companies, horizontal processes are not nearly as strong or well managed as vertical processes.
Well, these are interesting observations, Peter. Why do you think that companies are having such a difficult time achieving success in these five key aspects?
Well, good question, Dustin. I would say that historically, organizations have focused on building vertical strength. In other words, making the basic vertical processes of sell, source, make, and deliver efficient, effective, and predictable. So instead of aligning, these core corporate functions have competed for resources, for priority, for attention. This lack of functional alignment can impede the ability of an organization to orchestrate trade-offs across the company to maximize business opportunities, optimize corporate performance, and mitigate risks. As companies have shifted from a vertical to a horizontal focus, there has been a similar shift in focus from inside out, that is, organization out to the market, to an outside-in perspective, that is, from external markets back into the organization. This market and customer-driven focus, which we also call an adaptive or demand-driven approach, help companies more rapidly sense and adapt to market and channel changes and orchestrate integrated processes to help mitigate supply risks. This is also the broad definition of agility.
Are there any specific ways that supply chain and general managers can drive their S&OP initiatives to achieve tighter integration between planning and execution? And also, more importantly, how to make their organizations more demand-driven?
Well, I believe the key to any successful S&OP initiative is the ability of the organization to align demand, supply, inventory, and financial plans easily and seamlessly against the overall business strategy. This requires a technology layer to enable demand translation. That is, the modeling of changing product mix and the visualization of equivalent units. This technology layer then becomes the system of record tying together the multiple S&OP points. However, this alone is not sufficient to sense and define a response to buy and sell side market changes. All too often, plans are built on internal enterprise data and not external market data. In addition, the process definition is inside out. In other words, enterprise data is used to predict future market shifts rather than outside in, where market data is used to sense and shape responses based on external market shifts. The most effective S&OP processes use both demand and sell side market data to bi-directionally align the organization from market to market. As the company shifts from outside inside out to outside in, data models must also be redefined and the technologies re-architected to reflect this profound change in orientation. These are fundamentally different data models. Another common barrier to achieving S&OP excellence is that companies are not sufficiently deliberate in their statement of goals, definition of government practices, or the definition and alignment of key performance metrics. While companies universally state that they want to improve their S&OP processes and want to be agile, they often struggle to define what this means specifically for their company in order to make it actionable.
Well, this is really a good, a lot of information to digest, but how would you wrap up and summarize what we've covered during this interview?
Well, like many aspects of business planning, the devil is in the details. Supply chain concepts such as agility, resilience, efficiency, and economy are goals that are easy to talk about, but difficult to achieve. Fortunately, the principles of sales and operational planning offer management a disciplined approach to achieving these organizational goals. But S&OP is neither a simple solution, nor is it a short-term effort. It's a multi-year journey, and creating a demand-driven value network requires aspirational and highly advanced thinking. The good news is that companies who are the most advanced in S&OP also see the greatest improvements in corporate agility.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you.